myself, Professor Leo Patel from Indian Institute of Engineering and Technology for the Mobile Engineering Department. So we are in talk of subject vehicle dynamics, and also we have continued our fourth chapter, that is suspension system. Or we can say that from previous lecture that we have already discussed three main topics regarding suspension geometry. Like first is the antique pitch, antique roll, and antique die. So we have already discussed about these three effects of the suspension system and how these functions or how these geometry changes affect my overall performance of the vehicle that we have discussed already. So in today's lecture, we will talk about main three points, that are roll center, second is the roll center analysis, and the third one is the suspension geometry. So we will discuss one by one, that is what do you mean by roll center, how roll center is going to affect my overall stability of the vehicle, and the third one is the suspension geometry, that overall suspension, how we have to choose that particular suspension dimensions and their arrangements to accommodate or to compliances with the driver or riding performance. So let's begin with the first topic, that is roll center. So in this figure you can see that there are three different scenarios are given. First scenario, in which you will find the symmetric diagram. In the first figure you can see that the tire is there, also the same distance from the center of the vehicle, another wheel is there. So this is the condition where we have to see the vehicle from the back side. In the center you will find center of gravity, and at the below point you will find that X point, and that point is my roll center. So first of all, let us know how to find roll center of the vehicle. So to find the roll center, we need three imaginary axes. First is the upper arm, second is the lower arm, and the third one is the contact patch with the road. So you can see the intersection of three lines, and you will find instantaneous center. So we have already discussed about the instantaneous center, that how to find instantaneous center. So that center comes while the upper arm and lower arm intersect from the other tire. So we will find two instantaneous tire for left side and right side. So for that instantaneous line we will find roll center. So in the first figure where the symmetry has been taken, so at that point you will find that the roll center is below my center of gravity point. So that is my first case. If I'm talking about asymmetry, or we can say that the riding condition, we will find so different conditions according to road. So at that time what will happen, our roll center is going to change. So in the second case you will see the CG point and roll center point, there is a large difference or large gap in between there. And the third figure you will see that the gap between the center of gravity and roll center is less. So my ultimate aim is to reduce that point. Why? So if the distance between CG and roll center is very high, what will have, we have chances of rolling is going to be maximum. So at that time, so what will happen while we driving our vehicle, what will happen, the roll center is going to change in every road condition. So we have to maintain that roll center, and according to that we have to keep our suspension arms accordingly. So what are the main design goals? Like we have to choose roll center wisely, because the riding condition, driver's comfort, also the suspension selection, and so on. So this is for the rear wheels, but what we have to say, we need to find it for the front portion also. So in overall we will find two roll center points, and according to that two roll center point we will find roll center axis, and my vehicle is going to roll according to or with respect to that roll center axis. So from this concept we will find these two roll center for the front, roll center for the rear, and from that two points we will find roll center axis that is going to affect my overall performance and to select my suspension geometry. Moving further, here you can see that the roll center is with three points, in which you can see that this is the symmetric part of the suspension system. You will find these two instantaneous center, point A and point B, and the intersection point, that is my roll center. Moving further, here one condition is given in which we will find that the right tire is going to move upward due to the bad road condition, and at that time what will happen, our instantaneous center, you can see that from purple line, that is roll center with respect to my right tire, and the green point, that is respect to my left tire. So according to that road condition, what will happen, the instantaneous center of the right tire is going to be as it is, while the left tire, which is going to lift with the by road condition, and that point is going to be down. So the intersection point, so you will find that in yellow color, that is roll center point, so that is going to be lower with comparison with the symmetric symmetric geometry. So in this case, what will happen, the roll center is going to pull down, and the difference between the CG point and roll center is going to be maximum. So in that case, the chances of rolling of our vehicle is going to be maximized. So we need to keep in mind about the suspension geometry, and to design and how to implement the suspension geometry in my vehicle, that we have to keep in our mind. Moving further, as already said, that there are two instantaneous points. For first is for the front, the second one is for the rear. So after intersecting these two points, what we will find, we will find a roll center axis, that you can see over here, that is my roll center axis, and according to these axis, my vehicle is going to roll. For the front vehicle, or from the front wheel, the roll center is very below to the surface, while for comparing with the rear suspension, that is the maximum difference between the road surface to my overall roll center point. So this is my axis at which the vehicle is going to roll in rolling condition. Moving further, let us talk about suspension geometry. What do we want from a suspension geometry? Like, what are the different specification or the general ideas that we need from the suspension geometry? First is the four wheel independence. Like, my individual tires are going to affect individually to my overall vehicle, so it cannot affect my another tire while the rough surface is there. Second is the minimum weight, it should be less weight. Third is the minimum compliances of the structure. So we can say that the uncontrolled flexing of the parts are very low. Next one is the minimum compliances with the road surface. So according to road condition, my suspension going to react so smoothly that it cannot affect the driver or riding condition. Moving further, minimum camber change in hip. Hip means to pull or to push something or to lift something. So in that condition, again my suspension is going to react at that time. Maximum camber correction is there. Next is the negligible toe change in heave or rolling condition. So we can say that, these are the parameters we need to check while the vehicle is performing my different road conditions. Next one is the track change. So again, it is very minimal while in suspension condition. Next is the give the race engineer some adjustability. So it is the point where the driver can change some suspension parameters according to their habits or according to their driving condition. Again, maximum performance should be there, and we need to keep in our mind about the tire life, like it should be maximum. So according to that, we need to keep our suspension design. And the last one is the give the driver positive feel. Like if you are going to drive a vehicle, so you will find very smooth suspension wise. So these are the points that we have to keep in our mind while designing suspension geometry. So that is all about today roll center analysis, how roll center is going to affect, and the last one is the suspension geometry. Thank you.